In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, the Midpoint Formula. In numbers 1 through 8, our directions are to find the midpoint of each line segment. But what exactly is the Midpoint Formula? The Midpoint Formula helps us find the midpoint of a line segment, and that's going to be So the midpoint of a line segment is found using this formula. The x-coordinate will be x1 plus x2 divided by 2, and the y-coordinate will be y1 plus y2 divided by 2. And that's where coordinate x1, y1, so x1, y1 is one endpoint of the line segment, and x2, y2 is the other endpoint of the line segment. So basically, we're taking the x-coordinates of both the endpoints, summing them, and then dividing them by 2 to find the x-coordinate that's halfway in between. You could also think of this as 1/2 times x1 plus x2. And we're doing the same with the y's. We're summing the y-coordinates and then dividing that by 2 to find the y-value that's halfway in between the y-values of the endpoints. So now that we have an understanding of this formula, let's look at number 1. Our first step is going to be to find the endpoints. Our one endpoint, x1, y1, is at negative 5, negative 5. Our other endpoint, x2, y2, is at negative 1, negative 1. And whether negative 5, negative 5 is x1, y1, or x2, y2, doesn't matter. But now we're going to plug them into the formula. We're going to have the midpoint M equal to x1, negative 5, plus x2, negative 1, and that's going to be divided by 2, then comma, y1, negative 5, plus y2, negative 1. And that also is going to be divided by 2. And that's going to give us negative 5 plus negative 1, which is negative 6 divided by 2, and negative 5 plus negative 1, it's going to be negative 6, and then we're dividing that by 2 as well. So when we simplify, we'll get that the midpoint M is equal to negative 6 divided by 2, which is negative 3, and negative 6 divided by 2, which is negative 3. So the midpoint is negative 3, negative 3. And let's go ahead and double check. Plotting negative 3, negative 3, you can see we have to go over 2 and up 2 to get to one point, and we have to go over 2 and down 2 to get to the other point. So it is indeed the midpoint of the line segment. Now, moving on to number 2. Let's find our x1 and y1 coordinates. Our one coordinate is at negative 5, positive 5. So x1, y1, in this case, we're going to use negative 5 and positive 5. x2, y2, that's going to be 2, negative 5. Now let's plug these into the midpoint formula. We're going to have the midpoint equals x1 plus x2 over 2. So negative 5 plus 2 divided by 2, because here's my negative 5 for x1 and here's my 2 for x2. So we'll divide those by 2, and then we'll have y1 plus y2, which will be 5 plus negative 5. And we're dividing that by 2 as well. Since we're finding the point that's halfway in between x1, y1, and x2, y2. So we'll get that this midpoint is equal to negative 5 plus 2, which is negative 3 over 2, and 5 plus negative 5, which is 0, and then we're dividing that by 2. Simplifying this, we'll get that the midpoint is equal to negative 3 over 2 is negative 1/2, and then 0 divided by 2 is 0. So negative 1/2, 0 is our midpoint. So we're going to go negative 1/2, 0. And you can see that visually the midpoint is indeed halfway in between. And number 3, x1, y1, we have negative 4, 2 as the coordinate of one endpoint. And as the coordinate of another endpoint, we have 2, 2. So plugging that into our midpoint formula, x1 plus x2 is negative 4 plus 2, and we're dividing that by 2. And then y1 plus y2 is 2 plus 2, and we're dividing that by 2. So our midpoint is going to be equal to negative 4 plus 2, which is negative 2 divided by 2, and then 2 plus 2, which is 4, and we're dividing that by 2 as well. When we simplify, our midpoint is equal to negative 2 divided by 2, which is negative 1, and 4 divided by 2, which is 2. So negative 1, 2 is our solution in number 3. Negative 1, 2 would be right here. In number 4, x1, y1 is negative 4, negative 1. And then x2, y2 is 5. 3. So for our midpoint formula, x1 plus x2 is negative 4 plus 5, and we're dividing that by 2, and then y1 plus y2 is negative 1 plus 3, and we're dividing that by 2 as well. Negative 4 plus 5 gives us a positive 1 over 2, and negative 1 plus 3 gives us a positive 2 over 2. Simplifying this, we'll get that the midpoint of our line segment is 1/2, 1. So our x-coordinate is 1/2 and our y-coordinate is 1. And when we graph that, we go 1/2, 1. You can see that it is indeed halfway in between the endpoints. On to number 5, locating our endpoints. We have the point 0, 0, and we have the point 5, 4. Plugging the x-coordinates into our midpoint formula, we'll get 0 plus 5, and that's over 2. And then plugging the y-coordinates in, we'll get 0 plus 4, and that will be over 2. x1 plus x2, y1 plus y2, where here is x1 plus y1, and here is x2, y2. From there, 0 plus 5 is 5, and that's divided by 2. 0 plus 4 is 4, and that's divided by 2 as well. Simplifying that, 5 divided by 2 is going to be 2.5, since 2 goes into 5 2 times with 1 remaining. So this is 2.5, and 4 divided by 2 is a positive 2. So our midpoint is 2.5, 2. Going over 2.5 and up 2, we'll plot our midpoint. In number 6, one endpoint is at negative 3, positive 1. Our other endpoint is at 1, negative 4. So in our midpoint formula, I'm going to add the x coordinates, and the order in which we add doesn't matter, but I'll keep it consistent. Going x1, x2, and then y1, y2. So I'll have negative 3 plus 1 all over 2. And for my y values, I'll have 1 plus negative 4 all over 2. So as you can see, if I were to switch these and make it 1 plus negative 3, that's going to be the same. Or if I was to switch 1 and negative 4, negative 4 plus 1 is also the same. However, I cannot mix my x and y's. I have to add the x terms within the x coordinate, and I have to add the y within the y coordinate. So m is going to equal negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2 over 2. 1 plus negative 4 is negative 3 over 2. Simplifying, we'll get negative 2 over 2, which is negative 1. Negative 3 over 2 is negative 1.5. So going 1 to the left and 1.5 down, we'll reach our midpoint. In number 7, one endpoint is going to be at negative 1, negative 2. The other endpoint is at 4, negative 2. So for our midpoint formula, I'm going to add the x's together and divide those by 2. So negative 1 plus 4 divided by 2, and then I'm going to add the y coordinates together, negative 2 plus negative 2 and then divide those by 2. So negative 1 plus 4 is going to be 3, and we have that over 2, and then negative 2 plus negative 2 is negative 4 divided by 2. So the midpoint is going to equal 1.5. Since 3 halves can be written as 1.5, a negative 4 divided by 2 is going to give us a negative 2. So our answer in number 7 is 1.5, negative 2. So going over 1.5 in the x direction and then down 2, we'll get our midpoint. And the last problem I'll do in this video, number 8. But before I go over the answer to this, please remember to subscribe to my channel. All subscriptions are greatly appreciated, so go ahead and do that now. Also, while you're at it, go ahead and give me a thumbs up on this video to show me that you liked it and found it helpful. Now let's go over number 8. For x1, y1, we're going to have negative 4, negative 1. For the other endpoint, x2, y2, we're going to have negative 1, positive 4. So using the midpoint formula, we're going to add our x's, negative 4 plus negative 1, and we're going to divide those by 2, and then we're going to add our y coordinates, negative 1 plus a positive 4, and divide those by 2. So the midpoint is going to be negative 4 plus negative 1, which is negative 5 over 2, so negative 5 halves, and negative 1 plus positive 4 is going to be positive 3 over 2, so 3 halves. When we simplify, we can write each of those coordinates as a mixed fraction. So negative 5 halves is the same as negative 2.5, and 3 halves is the same as positive 1.5. And when I plot that, negative 2.5, and then I'm going to go up 1.5. So our midpoint falls at negative 2.5, 1.5.